and they is a bunch of side-elected, and the Libertarian Party can be the state party officially, or it can just be individual activists who go down and testify at the legislature and figure out bills that are Libertarian friendly or against bills that are not Libertarian friendly. I know a lot of those are going to enter in Texas, and they don't enter in these days, and it does provide us some visibility beyond just campaign season. And it's something where actually sometimes do impact legislation as well. So I'm just going to be able to get to change when legislation passes, that's great. And believe it or not, not that many people show up and lobby the legislature on a lot of issues. Certainly where some big companies going to get millions and millions, they've already got that lobby to figure out. There's more simple things that come up, maybe it's a property rights issue or decriminalizing marijuana or just election laws. Mm-hmm. They might hire a Republican Party where if a few people show up and say stuff, it actually can kill or help a bill pass. So I encourage that. Then also, if you do that and succeed, simply talking about that, or even if you go and advocate something and fail, now you've got a reason to run for state legislature the next election season. You can show up and say, look, I asked the legislature to pass this bill. It was going to taxes or decriminalize marijuana. They didn't vote for it. My legislature didn't vote for it. What's up there, Democrat? You're supposed to be for helping, you know, the little guy or poor folks, and they're not. So I'm running this for that reason. Of course, that brings back to elections and think about what we're focused on. But in between, we do have opportunities to activist spend and build credibility for future elections. One other thing is just by yourself and by the National Party. We are upgrading our website on a state basis. Things that we have time to do now that we definitely won't have time once it's time for national conventions and candidates by nationwide. If you can't take a little slow time, let your office read a little bit, go to ball games, and just a little bit, and get some of that infrastructure and preparation work out of the way. But it will be long before time starts for me. Because it's not as important as soon as we end up with again 2019.
Yeah.
chair. We don't have a county chair. Yes, I know you're busy. Yes, I know you're not going to be perfect, but will you please do it? And will you be nice to the new folks that show up? And do it until someone better than you steps up. And then the most important rule, this is how you keep going and we're going to kill it. The way you kill it is you say, you know what, let's cancel that meeting this month. You know, I'm kind of busy and there's only three people last month. Once you cancel that meeting and postpone it or totally cancel it, it gets really easy to cancel the next one as well. And suddenly 3 months have passed and everyone sees that the party's over. To me, the most critical thing for sustaining a local organization is having meetings routinely at the same time in the same place, month after month after month. Or if it's a quarterly meeting, make sure you do it every quarter so that people don't get your emails or don't read them or aren't paying close attention when they do things to go. They knew it was at the library.
Obstacles to move into the next level. So let's see. There's a question here and a question there. So one, two, I think. Question.
So what are the best?
We can be muscles.
we occasionally had a speaker come in, then again, group of people, most of them would never be seen again, I'm afraid. But those were the things we found.
Yeah, I don't agree with everything about the free state.